This is Jennifer with I Want You Colorado Springs, bringing you video interviews of local business owners and professionals. So tell us, who are you and what do you do?
I am Tara Smith, and I am a realtor with Coldwell Banker. And I recently just established my own business name, Realty 39.
Okay.
And I buy and sell houses with clients and serve their best interests.
So what made you go into real estate?
I've been in sales a long time, commission-based sales and service industry. And it's just something that I'm naturally good at, meeting people's needs and doing what's best for them. So I did property management for about 6 years, and I realized that I absolutely loved it. So I decided to go to bigger and better and see if I can help people make hearts happy and find their first homes and live the American dream.
So what's the market like in Colorado Springs? Sorry guys, I have to say, she was like, don't ask me that question. It's really sucky, actually.
It's very, very really difficult bad. Right now. But so. No, you know, I think it all depends on how you communicate
right.
as a realtor. So even though the market is very competitive, I've actually been able to get my clients under contract. It's all about communication and how you network and make the union between your clients, the other agent, and the other
right.
Side of the deal. You've got to make sure you're communicating and reaching out before you even make your offers.
Now, I've seen a lot of for sale by owners. So
yes.
What are your views on people deciding to do that because they're trying to just save a dime?
Well, you know, for a sell by owner, it's you know, you're trying to save a dime, but you might be losing a dollar because you're not necessarily as in the know of the market. Some
right.
people will say, I have friends who are this and friends who are appraisers and whatnot, but you really need the intellect of a real estate agent, for one, to protect your interests,
mm-hmm.
for two, to be able to negotiate on your behalf, go over your contracts, review the terms and conditions, and there's a lot more to it than just putting your house on the market and selling it. You've really got to know what you're doing, because this is a $200,000-$400,000 investment that
right.
you know, a few percentage points of that is really worth
right.
everything that we do for you, and just the protections that you have as a whole by going through a commissioned institution.
Now, I will say that this house is the first house I ever bought.
Oh, nice. Yes.
So it was very, you know, it wasn't as stressful as I thought it was going to be, thankfully.
Right.
So the real estate agent, unfortunately, I still haven't met her to
oh,
this day,
yes.
2.5 years
yes.
later, because I did buy the house sight unseen when I was in Florida, because we
right.
had to move. My mortgage company was really good, and you
yeah.
know, they worked with me, and being self-employed, that's always a challenge. So are there is there a certain segment of the population that you tend to like to work with?
I do like to work with first-time homebuyers, especially first-time homebuyers who are military. Younger, the millennials, and I think it's just because I feel maternal, and I try to, you know, help them learn how to get a good foot in the door
yeah.
now, so that when they're in their 40s and 50s, they're already developed and they can build a life. There's so much social capital that goes into owning a house. So
mm-hmm.
once you own a house, you can do so much more.
Mm-hmm.
So let's start now. You know, and a lot of them will tell me, I just want to rent because I don't want to go through it and I don't want to sell. But even still, if you're here for 4 years, you can
get
a lot of
money. Well, I tell you what, I heard one of my friends, she's paying as much rent
right.
as I'm paying on my mortgage. And
exactly.
my mortgage is ridiculously high because this is a giant house, because I
is.
Work from the house.
Yes.
So, you know, yeah, I mean, I think a lot of people have a misnomer. And Colorado Springs doesn't have a lot of rental stuff.
No,
so,
and that market is it's getting even more and more competitive, and the prices are driving more as we
right.
lose inventory on houses. And I think that a lot of people are afraid to sell because
mm-hmm.
they're like, how am I going to find something to buy?
Mm-hmm.
So it's really just kind of...
But yeah, because one of my friends, he was going to sell his house because they have a new baby that arrived.
Yeah.
And so he wanted to have something with another bedroom. And he was just like, you know, my sister looked and looked and looked, and she was having a really hard time. You know, people are putting $20,000-$30,000 over asking price.
Yeah.
You know, so it's just it is a challenge. But
yes.
you're saying that you're still able to, you know, work with most people, even though, you know, a lot of people are having these challenges.
Yeah, and I do. There's a correlation, I believe, in that based on my years of experience in the sales industry.
Right.
So it's all about the communication,
right.
again, like I said, and how you negotiate and the energy you put into
right.
your client. Each and every client of mine gets 110%.
Right.
Sometimes it's tiring.
Yeah.
You get some amazing listing opportunities at 3 and 4 in the morning, but I mean, sometimes you've got to be there waiting for a house to drop. And some of my clients, my last three, I think we went under market, under contract when the house hit the market, probably less than 2 hours.
Wow.
It's, you've got to be hawk-eyed.
Yeah.
Seriously.
Yeah, I mean, I can't even imagine. That's just like, it feels more stressful than what my Christmas time is probably like.
And I do think it is, and it's and you have to be there to be that grounding for those clients and
right.
let them know that they're not alone in this and there's other clients going through it. So don't think that every time you buy a home this will be the scenario, because
right.
it's just the way the market conditions are now. And hopefully, even if they don't slow down, hopefully people are still finding houses that they like and not just settling.
Oh,
because
right.
if you put in the right work, you can still find that the gem for them.
Now, do you just go here in the Springs, or do you go outside of the Springs as well?
The Springs, you know, Fountain Security, Whitefield, North, Monument. I don't go any further than Castle Rock. I can, but I think that would take away a lot of my time and energy towards other clients.
Right.
So,
but if
I'm
somebody
so far
here
out,
is looking specifically for something in like Denver, then you might help them.
I would refer them out to
okay.
to some fellow agents that I do
okay.
work with. Yeah,
well, that's
to,
good.
To be fair to my clients.
Yeah, well, that's nice too that you've got, you know, a group of people that you can call on for stuff like that. Working with a company like Coldwell Banker, you know, I
yes.
would just imagine helps with that.
Yes, we have some awesome networking and referral base, so that's great.
Nice.
I love the company.
Nice. Is there anything else that you want to tell the viewers?
Well, the only thing I can think is if you're thinking about buying a home or selling a home, a lot of times people like to say they're waiting for a certain time because they're waiting for certain things to happen in the market. And really, if you're ready to buy now, now is the time. If you're ready to sell now, now is the time. Trying to wait on the market and predict it, there is no crystal ball. And then some people try to wait and then they don't end up in the best position. So
right.
only thing I can say is buying is better than renting. And when you're ready, find an agent who will support you and help you stay ready.
Now, one of the things that you just mentioned, so it spurred another question in my head. So, like for me, if when I'm ready to sell this house, you know, I've got a lot of stuff I have to do before
yes.
I sell this house. But you know, since it's me and Jeff and it's a 6-bedroom, in your opinion, is it better to invest in having it staged for showings and pictures and stuff like that?
I think sometimes it really just depends. But being that your house is so large with 6 bedrooms. You probably want to have some staging, even if it's minimal. It doesn't have to be over embellished to where it actually looks staged, but you can have simple things like a rug on the floor with some pillows that are just on the floor, kind of more like little pockets and,
okay.
and flowers here. You don't have to go over and beyond with furniture, so
okay.
to speak. Little things here and there can always make a lot of
difference.
Because
that was one of my concerns is that, you know, obviously when we're ready to move, I have to move the business out and
yes.
then clean and, you know, make renovations and stuff like that, but then when it's ready, I have to, you know, make it look like somebody actually lives here and it's not an empty house. Because
that's
an
true.
Empty house is not, I mean, to me, in my mind, and tell me if I'm wrong, an empty house is almost as bad as having it either too cluttered or too personalized, right? Because you don't want your personal, you know, pictures and everything
right.
else around, because you want to make the potential buyer think that they could live there.
Right. And, you know, I won't say an empty house does a disservice, but I will say a large empty house definitely can have that impact. So just little things, I think, can be done at minimal cost, or even some of your own stuff that you have around the house placed strategically can
mm-hmm.
make a big difference.
Now, do you help people with that, or do you have a staging company that you can work with?
I don't do staging, but definitely we have stagers that we can hire that can do the work. And professional photography is the best thing. In
yeah.
an empty house, you can professional photography can really make a difference.
Yeah,
honestly.
And I'm sure you've got a ton of resources that you can call on to help buyers with various things like cleaning
yes.
or, you know, moving and stuff like that.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, a lot of people don't realize that as realtors, we don't just sell houses for our clients or help clients buy. We are like a referral resource as well. We can find you your cleaning service. We can find you your chimney
mm-hmm.
sweep. We can find you, you know, almost any and every type of need that you have. You know, we can't do everything, but there's
right.
a lot of different relationships that we have, and we can definitely refer you out. So that way you're getting a qualified referral instead of just looking through the phone book.
Right. And to me, your real estate agent should almost be like your best friend, your new best friend, because there's such a huge resource of information.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, and I always keep in contact with my clients even after the fact.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it may not be as in much detail,
right.
But I'm always there if you've got a question. And if I can answer it, I will. If I can't, I'll try to find you an answer.
Yeah.
Or sometimes I even see things after our deal's closed and I think about certain clients and I'll call and say, hey, remember that? And I'll pass the information
along.
That's
so awesome.
Yeah.
Well, if somebody wants to get a hold of you, how would they do that?
You can find me on Facebook. You can find me on Instagram at TRealty039. You can call me 719-208-0398. Or you can email me at TaraSmith@ColoradoHomes.com.
And I'll have
so
all those details, yeah.
Yes. We have a lot of links, yes.
Yeah. Awesome. Well, thank you so much for taking the time out to get interviewed today.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
You're
welcome. Thank you.
And as always, I Want You Colorado Springs is brought to you by GlassBlast.com, where you can get all your custom and personalized engraved needs. Thanks and have a wonderful day.